students, today I'll be starting with question number 3 of exercise 7.3. Now question number 3 says, replace box in each of the following by the correct number. Now in the first part we have 2 by 7 equal to 8 by box. We will have to replace this box by the correct number. Now here equal sign is given. Now equal sign means these and these are equivalent fraction. Okay, now here in this denominator, in this fraction, we have 2 in the numerator. Now here 2 is changed into 8, which is the numerator of the equivalent fraction. That means what should be multiplied to 2 to get 8? Now here 8 is bigger than 2. That means some number is multiplied by 2 to get 8. Okay, now there is a rule in fraction that if you multiply by any number to the numerator, the same number should be multiplied by the denominator. So what should be multiplied to 2 to get 8? It's 4. Now the same number to be multiplied by the denominator, okay, to get the denominator of the equivalent fraction. So 7 4s are 28. So the fraction will become 8 by 28. Okay. Now in the B part we have 5 by 8 equals to 10 in the numerator. We will have to find the denominator. Okay. Now here what should be multiplied by 5 to get 10? It's 2. So the same number to be multiplied by the denominator. So 8 2s are 16. Okay. Now in the C part we have 3 by 5 equal to box by 20, means denominator is given. We will have to find the numerator in the equivalent fraction. Okay, now how we have got 20? Here 5 is changed into 20. Now what should be multiplied by 5 to get 20? It's 4. Now the same number to be multiplied by the numerator. So 3 4s are 12. So the fraction will be 12 by 20. Now in the D part we have 45 by 60 is equals to 15 by box. So here we will have to find the missing number in the denominator. Now one thing we have to notice here, 45 is greater than 15. So here if you multiply by any number, you will get more than 15. So to get 15, we need to divide. Okay. Now what should be divided to get 15? Now if you see 15's table, 15 ones are 15, 15 twos are 30, 15 threes are 45, right? That means this 3 should be divided, okay, this 45 should be divided by 3 to get 15. So that same number to be taken to divide 60. Okay, now here always remember, if you multiply or divide, we will have to take the same number to multiply or divide the numerator and denominator. Okay, now here when you will divide 60 by 3, we'll get 3 2s are 6 and 0 will be here, so it's 20. So the fraction will become 15 by 20. Now in the last part we have 18 by 24 is equals to box by 4. Okay, now here again 24 is bigger than 4. So that means we cannot multiply here. We have to divide as smaller number is there. Now what should we divide? Which number should we take to divide 24? Now 4, 6 are 24. That means if you divide 24 by 6, you will get 4. Okay. So we will divide by 6. And that means we will have to take the same number to divide the numerator as well. So 6 3s are 18, so the fraction will become 3 by 4. So what we have learned in this sum, to get the equivalence fraction, either we will have to divide or multiply. But we will have to always, we will have to take the same number to divide or multiply the numerator and denominator to get the equivalent fraction. Okay, so this was all about question number 3. Now coming to question number 4. Now question number 4 says, find the equivalent fraction of 3 by 5 having, here we have 4 parts, denominator, in the first part we have denominator 20 given, Now this is same as the previous one. Now here we have denominator 20. Okay, we have the fraction given, which is 3/5. We will have to find the equivalent fraction of 3/5, and here it is given the denominator 20. Denominator means which we write in the down, right? So here we will write 20. Now see here, 5 has become 20, and since 20 is bigger than 5, that means we will have to multiply. So now what should we multiply by 5 to get 20? It's 4, because 5 was the 20, and there is a rule in fraction that if you multiply or divide, whatever you do, you will have to take the same number to divide or multiply the numerator and denominator, right? So if the denominator is multiplied by 4, then numerator also will be multiplied by 4. So it's 3/4 is 12. Okay, so the equivalent fraction of 3/5, if the denominator is 20, then it will become 12/20. Okay, now in the next part we have 3/5. We will have to find the equivalent fraction in which numerator is 9. So we will have to find the denominator. Now again, 9 is bigger than 3, right? That means we need to multiply. So what should we multiply by 3 to get 9? It's 3. So the same number to be multiplied by the denominator. So 5 3 is 15. So the fraction, equivalent fraction, will become 9/15. Now coming to C part. In the C part, we will have to find the equivalent fraction of 3/5 in which denominator is 30. So again, 30 is bigger than 5, so we will have to multiply. Now which number should we take to multiply 30? It's 6, because 5 6 are 30. So same number we will have to take to multiply the numerator. So it's 3 6 are 18. So the fraction will become 18/30. Now in the D part, we have numerator 27. So we will have to find the equivalent fraction of 3/5 in which 27 is the numerator. Okay, so that means what should we multiply to get 27? 27 is bigger than 3, so we will have to multiply, and we will have to multiply by 9, because 3 9s are 27. Similarly, we will have to multiply the denominator also by 9. We will have to take the same number up and down to multiply or divide. Okay, so it's 5 9s are 45. So the fraction will become 27/45. Okay, now this was all about question number 4. Now coming to next question. Now question number 5 says, find the equivalent fraction of 36/48 with numerator 9. So here we have 36/48. We will have to find the equivalent fraction of 36/48 in which numerator is 9. Now see here, 36 has become 9. So here number is getting smaller. So when the number gets smaller, that means we need to divide, right? Now which number should we take to divide 36? Okay, so let us read the table of 9. So 9 1s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 9 3s are 27, 9 4s are 36. That means if you take 4 to multiply 9, we'll get 36. So that means here 4 9s are 36. So 4 we will take, we will take 4 to divide 36 to get 9. Okay, now since we have taken 4 to divide 36, so the same number to be taken to divide 48. Now 4 12s are 48, so the fraction will become 9/12. Okay, now in the B part we have denominator 4. So we will have to find the equivalent fraction of 36/48 in which denominator is 4. Now what should we multiply to 4 to get 48? Now here we can see that 48 has become 4. That means number is getting smaller. So we have to divide. Now which number should we take to divide 48? If you read the table of 4, then 4 12s are 48 comes, right? So that means 4 12s are 48. Right, so 48 should be divided by 12 to get 4, right? So the same number to be taken to divide 36. So 12 threes are 36. So the fraction will become 3 by 4. Okay. So this was all about question number 5. Thank you, students.